Soltec's product manager. Today I'm going to talk about our bifacial tracker and how to simulate it in different softwares. Here we can see what we are going to talk about, a brief introduction of Soltec, our track record, our bifacial experience, some preliminary concepts, and how to simulate bifacial projects. I'm going to turn off my camera so you can see better the slides. Soltec is a company based in Spain, but with subsidiaries and projects around the world. We've sold more than 10 gigabits, and in the last years, we've sold more than 3 of them with bifacial technology. So bifacial tracker, more than a tendency, it's a reality. We've been in the industry for over 16 years, and nowadays, we are more than 1,600 people. Our experience in bifacial began in 2015 with a 1.8 megawatt plant that was installed in Chile, called La Silla, and there we achieved a bifacial gain of 15.7%. Later on, we evolved that product to integrate it in our SF7 product line to take into account the different factors that affect the bifacial gain from the tracker's perspective. In 2018, we opened BITEC, the Bifacial Tracker Evaluation Center, in California, where we have been testing with different factors such as GCR, different albedos, and different configurations. In particular, the one portrait versus two portrait configurations. And in 2019 and 2020, we've reached the 3 gigawatt in projects with bifacial technology, mainly in Brazil and Mexico. Here we can see the different factors affecting the bifacial gain. Obviously, there's PV module bifaciality, but this is a parameter set by the PV manufacturer. Then we have the factors affecting the rear irradiation, such as PIT, that is a layout feature, albedo, a soil feature that could be improved by albedo enhanced material. In fact, we use one albedo enhanced material in BITEC. And their racking features, height and rear shadow. After La Silla project, we knew the different factors affecting the rear irradiation and therefore the bifacial gain. So when we evolved our SF7 to the SF7 bifacial, we took in consideration these two parameters. We opened a gap not only to avoid the shading of the short tube and the slimming drive, also to improve the cooling effect of the higher height. To estimate the bifacial, we need to estimate the rear irradiation. To understand and to estimate the rear irradiation, we need to talk about a few concepts. First of all, view factor models only consider the fraction of irradiation reflected by surfaces. In the simplest cases, for example PVsyst, it is considered that shaded surfaces do not reflect any irradiation. Thus, tracker applied view factor models only account for normalized tracker height, considering that the light behaves similarly when the geometric relations are steady. Ray tracing is a modeling method for calculating the path of waves or particles through a system. It has been applied in lighting design or for buildings and in the video game industry with the game to analyze indoor light behavior in the presence of multiple reflecting surfaces. This simulation tool provides a physically realistic image representation and a lighting map that are useful to obtain a detailed profile of solar panel rear irradiance. Then it is possible to simulate and analyze the specificities, the particularities of bifacial modules and their performance in the tracking systems. Mismatch power losses are caused by the electrical power output of PV cells, which is conditioned by the performance points of its IV curve. One of the most significant mismatch losses is caused by rated and peak module power deviations, normally under 2%. Albedo is defined as the fraction of the incident sunlight that the surfaces reflects. In the area of photovoltaic energy, ground albedo is evaluated as the ratio between global irradiation and reflected irradiation through the day. It is a fraction between 1 and 0, and it changes with soil. Here we have a typical value that we could have in a place that changes a lot through the seasons. In BITEC, as I said, we use an albedo enhanced material that allows us to get an albedo of 55.6%. With the same conditions, the bifacial gain of the two portrait tracker was 15.7%, meanwhile the one portrait was of 13.6. So we have a difference of 2.1%. This has been due to the effect of cooling of the 2P configuration and thanks to avoid the shading with the third tube. Since the time is limited, I don't want to extend more in the data of these 2 years in BITEC. We'll talk a little bit more in the different slides that we have, but anyway, you can read more about it in our website at soltech.com. When we talk about the cooling effect in the 2P versus the 1P, we talk about the difference in temperature due to the higher height of the 2P configuration. In this slide, we see that the temperature measured at the same time in the same plant in 1P and in a 2P with an average difference of 3.5 degrees Celsius. This directly affects the energy because, as we know, the crystalline silicon PV panels are affected by temperature. The higher the temperature, the lower the operating voltage, which results in less energy generated. In this particular case, it translates into a loss of 1.3% of energy. There are other determining operational factors that impact on bifacial generation. Module height is important for bifacial energy yield. In an operating plant with seasonal ground, the reflective surface is no longer the ground, but the grass. That means that the relative height of both 1P and 2P trackers decreases although significantly more in 1P when grass grows. The graph shows that the relative height on 2P tracker, or the orange line, decreases more slowly and has a greater relative height when the grass grows, the gray line. As we mentioned at the beginning, another factor that affects the rear radiation is the GCR, but it should be noted that more than the GCR, the ground coverage ratio, what is important is the pitch. When we have more distance between trackers, there is more albedo because there is more ground surface that is reflecting towards the rear side of the module. Here in the table, we see that for different pitch, we have different bifacial gains that are resulting from that greater area that is reflecting from the ground. By increasing the GCR when we use bifacial technology, we have a kind of boost due to the albedo and pitch. With monofacial modules, when you increase the pitch, you only have a longer tracking time because you avoid more shadows and you start the backtracking later. But in bifacial, when you increase the pitch, you not only increase these hours of tracking, but you also improve the rear gain. Another factor to consider is the maximum tracking range. In the case of the bifacial trackers, comparing a maximum range of 60 degrees versus one of 50 degrees, what we do is increase the tracking of the front side. With bifacial trackers, the natural thing is to increase the pitch. So what we get increasing this range is to reduce the backtracking time, maximizing the front gain, but also improving the rear gain. TeamTrack is our algorithm package for improving plant performance, whether the plant is bifacial or not. It is mainly responsible for avoiding shading between trackers during sunrise and sunset. Thanks to the fact that our trackers are independent, they don't have a mechanical connection between them, it allows us to optimize the angle of each one of them so they are disoriented in such a way that we get the maximum from the whole plant. That is why we call it TeamTrack. For example, on a diffuse day, bifacial TeamTrack can reach up to 8.3% more. If we talk about mismatch, we can compare at module level or string level. On a module level, although the worst view factor of 2P trackers should make one think that 1P trackers would perform better, BITEC data shows us the opposite. This is explained due to the higher panels, long time tilt through through the day lead to a better distribution of the rear radiation and to a better diffuse energy capturing. Also, 2P trackers experience a mirroring effect produced by the solar radiation passing through the gap between the panels and the tour tube that is reflected from its surface. It causes a positive mismatch that increases the bifacial gain and partially compensates the radiation mismatch due to the view factor. We'll talk about this later, but here you can see typical values for 2P and 1P. If we talk about mismatch at a string level, modules up and down in 2P trackers are exposed to different level of irradiation to their geometry. This difference is more evident when the tracker angle is higher. The effect in electrical production of these differences has been measured at BITEC. One tracker with albedo 19% and GCR of 0.4 has been connected with two string configurations, with 8 modules placed at east, connected together in a string 1, and modules placed west are connected in a string 2. Each string has an independent MPPT, and inverter is oversized in order to avoid inverter clipping. 1500 volts 2P solar tracker standard configurations is a 3-string tracker, as we can see in the picture of the bottom. This string distribution and the radiation difference between the upper and the lower panels causes an electrical mismatch. Here we can also see the mismatch loss in a 2-string SF7 and also in a 3-string SF7, not being more than 0.26%. Here see the Sankey diagram, where we can observe these three parts when we simulate bifacial projects. The front energy input, the same than the monofacial, the rear energy input, the new for bifacial, and the electrical that is similar to monofacial but increasing the energy through the current. PVsyst simulates very good the front radiation and the electrical operation of the plant, but for bifacial trackers there are a lot of radiation particularities where small details affects a lot. For example, as we mentioned in the preliminary concepts, here we see a comparison showing irradiation distribution along the tracker, revealing that view factor models don't reproduce progressive irradiation distribution. On the contrary, ray tracing models do simulate progressive irradiation distribution, just as it happened in real life, but it requires more computation time. The good thing of PVsyst is that we could modify different parameters to take into account everything we've been talking. BITEC developed guidelines to help customers to accurately simulate SF7 bifacial tracking PVsyst because the default parameters of the software didn't consider this. So here we can see the typical values at the values that you will need to introduce to simulate properly the project. Here is the summary. Here you can see the standard values that we have and also the values that you need to introduce in the SF7 bifacial. Field data from BITEC obtained from September 2018 and nowadays show a bifacial gain of 15.7% for individual bifacial tracking modules with an albedo of about 55%. Under seasonal albedo conditions, in which ground albedo changes through the year, the bifacial gain was 7.3%. Bifacial gain for 2P SF7 bifacial tracker is 2.1% higher than solar tracker with 1P configurations, and this difference is mainly caused by the lack of shading in the rear side of the module, by the higher position of solar panels, and by a lower operating temperature. The specific performance and advantages of bifacial modules can be simulated using available software such as PVsyst, but introducing properly the bifacial parameters. To do that, it is necessary to adjust the values for structure shading factor, shed transfer infraction, field thermal loss factors, and mismatch loss factors. Thank you very much, and thank you for hearing us. And if you have any question, please just send me an email. Here you can see my contact data, and I'll be happy to reply to you.